back for more potion craft. Hello, and welcome to day 12 of potion craft. Now, in our last episode, we've almost finished up this alchemist path, chapter 3. All we have left is to repair that alchemy machine in the basement, and then we'll get that 1500 book point experience boost, which I am so looking forward to. We're up to level 20, and I think that means we want to increase our trading just by 1 point. It loses just 2 upgrades for 1 point, and then the rest are 2 or 3. So, definitely starting to move into the middle or late game. We'll come in, grab our herbs. Ooh, we got 8 water bloom. We were really starved on that one last time. So that's pretty good. Pretty solid haul. At least we can go east now, and a little bit north. Let's see what we have. Ah, yes. Hello, Mr. Miner. Brolt crystals. Rare. Expensive. You buying? Finally. Something that is not expensive. I'll take that and the frost sapphires, I'm sure. So let's take this and 3 frost sapphires. 255. Too much. Too much. We're going down. 210. That's much better. Thank you very much for coming by. And I'm glad that I can finally buy something that you sell. Hello. I came for your help. I made a bet with guys that I could catch this one fish. I would do it, but it's going to hurt. It can tear the rod out of your hands or pull a fisherman right into the water. I won't manage without one of your potions. What kind of potion do you need exactly? Well, for example, a potion that makes me stronger. Then I'll definitely get that fish. Or maybe I could feed it some kind of soporific bait? What does soporific mean? Hold on. Define soporific. Tending to induce drowsiness or sleep. So he wants a sedative or something to make him stronger. Okay. So he gives us 2 options. That's really nice of him. So we could do that one. That's to the east, or we can give him strength, which is maybe Berserker Rage, maybe? We do have a recipe for that. Let's check our recipes. We could brew it. It's 4. No. We only have 4 Wind Bloom. So it's better to go for the Sleep Potion, because we got 8 Water Bloom this morning. So let's go with that. We'll go, let's say, Terraria. We'll grind. Grind it up. Change that Mortar and Pestle to that beautiful green color. Put that in. And we'll do a bit of swishy swish with that. Then we can just water bloom all the way across, I think. It's a bit of an expensive potion, but of the 2 options, we have way more water bloom, so I'm happy to do it this way. 1, 2, 3. Go a little bit low on this one. 4, again, a little bit low. And once we get here, we'll recenter the map. Zoom right in. Let's see if we can get this right on the dot. We're gonna oversheat it a little bit, but this game does have a mechanic to help with that. This wonderful little bit of water will always pull you back to the middle. So we just pour it in, pour, then finish a little bit more downwards, and then pour. We are so close. Going for that tier 3 potion. I think you need like a 95% coverage on the potion area, so it's definitely not easy to get, but there it is. Strong potion of sleep, and I think we can save this. I don't know if we'll ever have a more efficient recipe than 5 Water Bloom and 1 Terraria, so we'll save that. Oh, and I was going to rename that. We call that ZZZ Quill TM, something like that. And let's change the potion bottle to be something that looks like a tincture that you would drink at night. Put like a, I guess it doesn't really matter what we put on this one. It's too small to notice. Some sideways Z's. Ooh, that's a good idea. There we go. Then colors. Let's do a little bit of a more muted palette. That. Maybe a bit more purple. Yeah, that's good. We'll keep that. ZZ Quill TM. Perfect. Hello, good sir. There you are. This potion is perfect. I know it is. I brewed it. All the way back across. 82. I'll take it. I found him! The bandit who killed my buddies. He's huge and covered in armor from head to toe that no sword can pierce. But I don't need a sword. I'll dip an arrow in poison and shoot him right through his visor. His death will be slow and painful. So, these kind of characters, some of them are evil, and that's what our reputation score is. In our last episode, we definitely chose a bit of the evil path, but they paid me really well, so it all worked out. But this guy seems pretty virtuous. He's doing this just for his friends that died. So I think we can believe him. Poison is pretty easy to get to, as long as you have the ingredients, of course. It's Terraria, full grind, and then it's just Firebells across. Firebell, all the way. You know what? I bet you the most efficient recipe for this is just to go to halfway point, right to this point right above the crushed up firebell, which I think we have a little bit more crushing to do. There we go. Maybe we can burn a sulfur shelf just to fix this up a little bit. I think I have a better recipe in mind. I'll try it right after this one. Come in, then this arcs us around. We line up those two arrows. There are indicator arrows, so this line goes from the middle to the poison. So if you can line up your line with that line, then brew it in. Go a little bit to the left, a little bit more water, a little bit more to the left, and then the rest is water. Here we go. You line them up, and it all works out. I'm not going to save this recipe. We'll just finish it up. And then I do want to try out that other one. Do we have enough terraria? Not really. Maybe at the end of the day, we'll try and make our most optimized poison possible. There we go. The potion will do, but I will pay... What? Well, this is the poison 2 that we made last time. Poison 3. There we go. Alright. So we go in on this side. Click, 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 click. Boom. Perfect. Thanks for coming by. And it was a good deal. He isn't bad, he's not good, he just has a virtuous attitude, I guess. My apple tree produced very few apples this year. What will I sell at the market now? Do you have a potion that will produce a better apple harvest? Yes! Finally! Somebody wants a rich harvest potion! She'll pay more for something higher grade. So, normally I'd be cool with that, but it's all the way over here. That's where the harvest is. And we're really low on water blooms, we don't want to start using our frost sapphires. So this is all you're going to get, but I will haggle more money out of you. That is my guarantee to you as the shop owner and potion creator. Plus 3, plus 1, very nice. Oh, my favorite lady. I brought some herbs for you. Need any? Why are you always selling herbs?
Ha! I don't gather the same ones every day. I know a lot of good spots, but they're far apart, and I must give them time to grow new crops to pick.
That's very considerate of you, environmentalist.
What?
51?
Lady, come back! Lady, come back, I'll make that potion for you! Yo, we're stocking up. 100 gold worth, 15 water blooms. Let's make it 20 water blooms. We're kind of low in terraria as well, so let's just grab 8 of those. Firebells, we're still great on. Windbloom, oh, that's a stupid price for windblooms. We're not paying for that. I think that's as good as we're gonna get. And 218, we could probably push this to like 25 water blooms. That'll hold us for a while. And then we haggle it down. Ooh, you're on, lady. Click, 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 click. Boom. 190 instead of, what was it? I can't even remember. We saved so much money on that haggle, though. All right. Thanks for coming by. Oh, it's definitely not Geralt.
Hello, alchemist. The residents of a nearby village asked me to deal with the ghouls that have been terrorizing them. Apparently, they have a nest somewhere near the village. To destroy it, I need a bomb, or at least something combustible. Will you help me?
Can't you make your own potions?
I can make some, of course, but it's best to trust a professional in this matter.
Thank you!
And there is absolutely no time to lose. Besides, if I have a free moment, I prefer to spend it with the ladies. Or playing dice.
At least he's honest. Honesty is such a good quality. Hold him to it, and let's make him that explosion potion. We can only brew one more of this. Ah, we're gonna be almost out of wind blooms. But for not Geralt, we need it. For him, I'll do it. Here you are, Geralt, not Geralt. Ooh, what happened to the, that on my screen? No, that's the game. Looks like the text is behind the etching mark. Okay, let's haggle that out. 129. Enjoy that, Mr. Geralt.
Today the city guards are going to ambush some bandits. I need an exploding potion. I'll throw it when those scum are sitting around their campfire.
Why does everybody want explosive potions today? I just gave mine to Geralt. We can't brew another one. It's impossible. Well, we could probably figure something out. Let's see what we have. We have a bunch of ingredients that go like northeast, I believe. Let's see. Goldthorn, no. We had a shadow chanterelle, but we used it yesterday. We could do a sulfur shelf in place of one of the wind blooms. Let's see how that works out. We'll do a full grind sulfur shelf. We'll do a wind bloom, just like that. Bring it all the way to the top. Definitely can't waste those wind blooms on this one. Then a fire bell, We're gonna get close to the bones, but the next thing we do is probably another wind bloom, so it doesn't matter too much. We'll be out of there in no time. Then we'll bring it all the way to probably... Now, what does the sulfur shelf do? It does a bit of like a curvy arc. So all we really need is that. So we'll go with just that. Throw that in, and then we'll brew this up, and we'll see where the sulfur shelf can put us. Zoom in for this boneyard. I think we'll only be there for like a little bit. Yeah, just enough to scare us. There we go. We've lined it up. Sulfur shelf will get us right in there. Wow. You can see that it will get a second chance just by looking at it. So here is when it's going to be first, and then we'll come back around. This lines up with that side, so we can at least have a second shot at this. So let's give that a go. One. We're gonna line up this arrow right here. It's very faded, really tough to see, with this slightly darker one. Looks like a crease on the map, honestly, but it's really good for lining things up. So we do it like that. And then there's our arrow. We just bring it back with the water. One, two, three, boom. There we go, strong potion of explosion. And with the rest of this, we can bring it around and grab that last bit. So let's just finish it up. Here you are, a second person of the day that needs an explosion potion. Please use it responsibly. Kill the bandits, nobody else. There we are. I need a potion for my husband. He needs to sleep deep tonight. I don't want him to catch my lover and me vanishing into the- Hold up. Nope. Get out of my shop. Oh look, it's Naruto, who's asked to deal with that monster that's been attacking travelers at night. They say it's invisible. I don't know if that's true. But I could use a potion that allows me to see through invisibility. So this is the true vision. This one's really rough to get to. Do we have a witch's? No, we don't even have the witch's mushroom. What we could do is cheekily jump over. Yeah, let's use a frost sapphire. That'll be fun. We don't have a lot of them, but desperate times. Oh wait, no, we don't have any way to go up. Oh no. We're gonna have to deny service again. Tragedy. Pure tragedy. Well, sorry, Naruto. He's angry at me. I'm sorry. That was it. It's the end of the day. We have no more northward ingredients. So I think that's more or less it for this one. Let's move on to the next day. There's not much we can do without that wind bloom, or honestly, we need that herbalist to come by with a lot of wind bloom, and then we can buy her out. Let's see what we've got over here. Ooh, quite a collection. 3, 3, 4 is pretty good. 1, 5, 1, 1, 1, 1, 4, 1. Not a great amount for each one, but a little bit here and there always helps.
Greetings, it's been a while, Alchemist. Well, need to buy or sell anything?
What you got? Bloodthorn, that's pretty cheap. Thunder Thistle, it's not cheap, but without a lot of wind bloom, we could use it as like a more advanced one. I think we gotta do that. Yeah. So let's grab a good amount of this. Let's say like 10. It's gonna be an expensive one. And then a couple we don't really use Bloodthorn too much, so we'll just grab 2 or 3 of it. 350 gold already, so I think that's good for me. And we'll have to haggle this down really good. Go back once, maybe twice. No, those are getting really tiny. Okay, 278. Thanks for coming by. Come with better prices next time, please.
The cattle in our field are sick. One neighbor already lost a goat, and another lost a sheep. Now my cow has fallen ill. Got anything to help my beloved bovine feel better? I feel bad for her, and the farm needs milk.
Sounds like you just need a straight-up health potion. Don't worry, we at Retroflux Limited, LLC, Potion Alchemy, Academy, TM, we can be there for you. Good luck with the cow.
The foxes are getting into my chickens! If they keep this up, I'll be left with a coop and a rooster. I decided to scatter some poisoned bait around.
I don't think this is evil, but I don't want to spend any more money on it. So let's do just this. She'll pay more for a higher grade, but I think she'll pay more just for this. Here we go. Thanks for coming by.
Madam Twerks, the owner of the local brothel, came to me and asked me to come up with a special beer for her establishment that helps her clients feel liberated and awaken their inner beast.
I have the beer, but I don't know about the inner beast part. Do you know anything that could make it wilder?
Finally, it's time. Play the music.
Oh wait, no, it's DMCA. Never mind. There we go. We finally found somebody that will pay for our 400 gold potion. I do want to know about this. Does the city even have a brothel?
Yes, and it isn't bad. The girls are gorgeous, and also... I actually forgot what else. My friend told me about it.
Okay, let's try and get this to 200, then we'll have at least...
Oh, that was rough.
Bring it back. 97. So that's half price. We lost half of the money on our 20 potion run. I feel empty without that libido potion. I kind of want it back now. Maybe we'll brew another one.
Yesterday, there was an intense skirmish outside of town and between the guardsmen and bandits. There were many wounded, and us healers tended to them all night. We managed to save everyone, but spent a lot of energy, so I was looking for something to restore my magical powers.
So he needs, like, the equivalent of a health potion, but for magicians, which is... Da-da-da-da, mana potion. Do we have a recipe for this? No, we have Z-Z-Quil, almost what we need. But this one's pretty easy to do. Ooh, we could even use the Shadow Chanterelle to get kind of over there. But I do know the recipe for this almost up by heart at this point. It's one fully ground Wind Bloom, one fully ground Water Bloom, another fully ground Water Bloom. Now, you can bring it just a little smidge before, something like that. It's like 95% ground. Then you finish it off with a Wind Bloom, fully ground. This brings you right through the middle and up through the top. So when you do the watering at the end, it all works out. Then you go through, swirl, 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 swirl. Slow down, let's recenter our map and zoom in. There we go, let's get a level 3 mana potion for this healer. So we're gonna come up above it, just by a smidge. And water it in. There's two. And then do a bit more of it. Ooh, that might be a little bit too high. We'll see how it goes. Might have just messed it up by stirring a little too fast. Yep, looks like we did. So let's take that. That's the way to do it. Be a little bit slower, and it should work out pretty well. Pretty easy one to make, so I don't actually have to remember the recipe. It just takes a little bit of effort every single time. 58.
Oh, my favorite old man. Welcome back.
Hello. Need any mushrooms? Straight from the forest, of course. They even still have the morning dew on them. And a few worms, but I won't make you pay for those. Winking, winking. They're complimentary.
Why are mushrooms growing out of your hat? I feel like this is a question we should ask, you know, on the first day.
These are my special mushrooms. Humans can't smell them, but wild beasts fear their scent. When I was young, I would eat these mushrooms before going into the forest, but then I realized I could grow them on my hat.
Okay. You know what, dude? All of you. I believe in you. 100%. Let's grab some weird shrooms. We have 4, so we'll grab 2. Definitely need those Shadow Chanterelles. So we'll haggle this. Ooh, challenge accepted, old man. Click, 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 boom. 99. It's a deal. Thanks for that's the menu. Thanks for stopping by.
Oh, it's him again.
Greetings. I need a potion that allows me to hide from the eyes of unwanted witnesses. It's a difficult task, but I'm sure you'll manage it.
So this guy pays a lot of money, but he's evil. So we like him, but only, like, a little bit. I think we'll try and make it through this gap for that extra experience boost. Let's pretend we're making a mana potion. We'll start with the Water Bloom. Grind this right over to here. Not a full grind, just want that experience along the way. Level up, talent point. Bada bing, bada boom. And then we'll go for this one. That'll be another, we only have 2 Wind Blooms, okay. That witch mushroom, so that's our way into here. So we do Wind Bloom, Water Bloom, Water Bloom, witch. All right, Where's that witch mushroom? Oh, we can't actually use it for this. You know what? Let's not risk it, and let's just throw a frost sapphire into this. So this one, see how it has that little swirl? Ooh, it has a beautiful noise when it breaks too. What it will do is let you go along the path, and you'll instantly teleport. So what I'll do is bring it all the way over to here. That's as far as I want to go, so we'll just leave it at that. Drop it in, and then, whoop! Ta-da! I think we can use the Thunder Thistle. We just have to be really careful with it. So, put it in, grind just a little bit. We want it about halfway. Something like, actually, you know what? We can just grind the whole thing. Not too concerned. Ooh, that's a beautiful color. Okay, and then we'll go a little bit up. And then water. This is going to be how we're going to do it. We're going to try and line up one of these curves over here, close to the diagonal. As we go up, we're going to just keep lining it up with this line right here. So right to there, bring it in. Ooh, that's almost perfect. A little bit of water, just a smidge. There we go. And then we need a little bit of north. So we'll just eke it up about there, and water once more. There we go. So that's the level 3. Strong potion of magical vision. Now what we can do after this is continue stirring, grab that, and grab that, and then say that's it. That's all we can do. Here you are, my dastardly friend. Wait. Oh, this is magical vision. He wants invisibility. Ah, I bamboozled myself. Invisibility, we've never seen that before. Well, I guess we can try and find it. Let's do a bit of an adventure. We'll go to about here, and then maybe we'll use another frost sapphire to get across. Go Thunder Thistle, full grind. Grind, 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 grind. Throw that in, then water bloom. Grind, 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 grind. Smash, 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 smash. That wonderful noise of water bloom being crushed. Smush, mish. It's just such a squishy noise. It's so gross. Throw that in. And we'll do a Thunder Thistle. Ooh, that's going to be real close. We might have to use a bit of water, but that'll be good. It's up to there. Yeah, I think I'll do a bit of stirring. And then just a little bit of water. And then we'll just go across here. As we go farther east, the water has a more potent effect on the westerly direction, so we can pull it down like this. That'll help us avoid the bones. Still a little bit scary, but we make it through. And there we go. So to get to here, well, maybe we have to go up here. You see this line right here? That is telling us that there is something up there. I'd wager it's somewhere closer to true vision. But I've never done this before, so take what I say with a grain of salt. We can get a little bit northward. We have one wind boom left, and I think this is the time to use it. Crush, 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 smash, smash, crush. There we go. Experience, experience. Mix, swirl, mix. Okay, and then we can come in with Shadow Chanterelle, maybe with a little bit of water. Let's do a bit of water to start. Something like that, a little bit more. That's pretty good, let's give that a go. This is still gonna be really risky. But that's pretty good, and we can even do a little bit of water to start. So we'll do the water first. Throw this in so we can see where it's gonna path to. That's pretty good. Ooh, it's gonna be a little bit dicey at the end. We might have just messed ourselves up with that one. Oh, there is something up there. Okay, so the way to get out of this is probably a crystal. I think it'll be a crystal out because we can't move. At least not effectively. Maybe a Thunder Thistle could get us out, but it's just gonna get us into the bones again. Risk it for a red mushroom into Witch's Mushroom, maybe? I think, yeah, I'd prefer to do this. We can save the, yeah, so we saved it, good. If we can save the crystals, those are expensive and hard to get, so it's always better. Witch mushroom into Thunder Thistle? I think that's... Thunder Thistle pushes us...
Oh, this is so complicated.
Can't I have normal ingredients? So if we can get to this book, then we're good. So I think it's gonna be witch mushroom and some water. Gotta get as much north out of this as we can. Definitely gonna be fighting with the water for this one. Go up, and then got the book, which is cool. We're actually gonna lose distance on this one. Yeah, it's a little too far south. Just gotta bring it all the way back, wow. Ooh, okay, so we still have the Thunder Thistle. That could bring us in line. A little bit risky, but I think we'll take it. We'll grind just to this right here. Wah! Things we do for this evil person. Thunder Thistle. I mean, it's as good as it's gonna get. Maybe we throw a bit of water into it, but can't say no to this. And I just have to live with it now. We're gonna be sliding across these bones a lot. Okay, hold your breath. Ooh, we made it. Okay. Here's level one. We're lined up really well for a Firebell. Actually, we could do Firebell into Water Bloom, just for the experience gain. I think I like that. Bring it across like this, and stop at the top-ish area like that. Now we're getting greedy. I understand the greed. This is part of me. And Water Bloom always has a bit of a south to it. So we bring it in and then do a full grind. Just in case we have the opportunity to grab that book at the end. But I don't think we will. We can go for it, though. Okay, center it up. And then, here we go. And we line up those two lines, just like that. And a little bit of water, just gently. Perfect. Whew. This better be it. Invisibility. Let's call this spooky ghost. Spooky, scary, skeleton potion. Definitely needs a different bottle. I feel like this is something you would probably... You store this in a mason jar? No. Something like this, like a flask. Ooh, that. Pop the cork, drink it, do your nefarious deeds. I don't think we're gonna be saving this recipe. It's more good that we just know that it's up here. Finish this up, grab that experience, and then, because we're already over here, the best thing we can do is continue exploring, grab some of this. There's another potion over there. So let's be a little bit mean to this guy and mess his potion up a little bit. That. So right now we can go through this. That's almost perfect. I think that is perfect. All we can get is a level 2 though, so we'll just stop short. I don't want to mess up his potion itself. Just brew that one up. Hallucination. Hope you like it, friend. It might give you a bit of hallucinations. Okay, and then let's grab some of this. There's a triple book down there, so let's line it up. Finish this one off, and then straight down, Terraria, we'll collect the rest, and then we're done. Don't want to get too greedy, and this is definitely on the greedier side of things. But look at our experience bar going up, it's just good. It's good for the soul. There we go. Created Potion of Hallucinations and Invisibility. So, Here you go. He thinks it's perfect. He doesn't know about the hallucinations part, though. There we go. Lots of women in that set of tiles to click. That might be the hallucination part. There's the negative 30, but we get almost 300 gold from that, so we can't say no.
Our village is preparing food for a local holiday. There will be dancing, reveling, and mountains of food. We also want to hang lanterns all over town that will burn for several days until the celebration ends. Do you have anything that will burn longer than oil or candles?
Yes, by the holy light, we do. Can we get to it? No, not at all. Do we have anything that can pretend to go up? We've got the Thunder Thistle. We could do this. Let's throw another Thunder Thistle. We have 5 left of this. So we can go a little bit south to avoid those evil bits. Then Firebelt always has the opportunity to track a little bit upwards. So we'll do that for the first one, and we'll get a bit of that distance as well. You know what, we can do it all the way, and then we can use the last one to really know where we're going. There we go. And then the final fire bell lines up almost perfectly. That's pretty good. I will be happy with a 2. Like, a 2-star is pretty okay for me here. So let's do a bit of a Thunder Thistle, and then double fire bell. Bop, bop, bop. If we can get the 3 on the first pass, that's our best chance at it. 2, 3. Beautiful. We'll save this recipe. We'll call it Thunderous Light. No, let's pull a Hearthstone reference.
By the holy light!
Actually, let's make it by the holy light. There we go. Here you are. Exactly what you need. But I need more. 56. I'll take it. Haven't seen you before.
I'm an adventurer, and I recently came across some ancient catacombs. I think their depths may contain great treasures.
How do I know? Because an iron golem is blocking the way. The problem is no fire, poison, or frost will take it down. I need something else.
This might be an acid. Let's see. We can brew this, so let's brew one up. And see if you want this. Yes, 200 gold. Click, 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 click. Oh, I missed that one. Ah, 200 gold. Level up. Very nice.
Recently, I managed to get my hands on a chest, but it has a very intricate lock that I can't open. And the chest itself is so strong, I can't even sledge it open. Can you help me open it?
Do you want another poison? Acid might be your solution as well. Yep, it is. Another 200 gold, ready to go. Bop, bop.
Oh, I missed it.
I think we take the second pass. There we go. 224. Oh, that was negative. I thought it was noble intent, just an adventurer. That brings us to 1,500 gold. If we get the person tomorrow, that allows us to haggle for the alchemy machine. Then that's really good. We can use the extra 5% from our talent point. Maybe that's enough to get our haggle to enough. And then we can, you know, actually buy it on day 14. That's so early. But for now, that will be it. Tomorrow is day 14, and we'll start and maybe finish chapter 3. Of the adventurer, nope, not the adventurer, the alchemist's path. And after that, well, we're almost done chapter 4, and we just started on chapter 5 with that invisibility potion, so definitely a little bit ahead of the game. We'll see how this goes from there. Thank you so much for coming along. Check out the rest of the content on this channel, and I will see you in the next one.